In today's video, I'm going to show you how. So the first thing we got to do is import our footage into the project. And we're going to do this by filming two things. One clean plate, which is a clean background, and enacting. In this case, I did both in one single clip. And as you can see, I have a clean background here. Then I walk into frame, do my acting, and sneakily get out. So having that, let's make our cuts. I'm gonna cut it right here, where I'm already in frame, and another cut right here where we've got the clean plate. And we can actually make it a freeze frame. We can do that by hitting Shift R on the keyboard. And what we're gonna do is put our acting one layer above and keeping our clean plate in the first layer. Once we do that, we're gonna select both clips, right click them, and then create a new Fusion clip. So let's head over to Fusion. So if you did everything accordingly to what I said, you should have your clean plate right here on the background, or this yellow arrow right here, and you're acting on the foreground at this green arrow right here. So to make this easier for us to work, let's change the positions, but keep in mind that we didn't change the arrows. All we did was change their place in the node tree. And we have our media 1 on the first viewer and our media 2 on the second viewer. And let's rename them. You can do that by clicking the clip and then hitting F2 on the keyboard. Let's name it plate, and let's name our acting, well, acting. And we can delete our merge for now. Let's delete this as well, and let's begin. So the first thing we're gonna do is make a mask in our acting. So let's grab a polygon mask, let's come to viewer 2, increase the image, and mask out the character. If we were doing a professional effect, the right thing to do would be rotoscoping the footage. But for these purposes, we don't need to be that accurate. Just a rough mask around the character will be fine. And let's take a look at the footage to see if everything is inside the mask. Okay, let's fix this part here. Let's see now. Okay, let's connect our mask to the acting. We have our acting separated from our background. And now we're gonna start working with the particles. So I've already made a video here on the channel with an introduction to particles using almost the same effect but with a logo. So if you wanna check that out first, I'm gonna leave the link in the description. Okay, let's grab our p-emitter and a p-render. And our p-emitter is our main particle emitter, and the p-render is where everything we do with our particles is being rendered, as you can imagine. So let's connect both. Let's put our pre-render in viewer 2 and make sure we're set to 2D. We can already see many particles, but to make that look better, we're gonna come to p-emitter and change our number of particles from 10 to 70,000. And that's gonna make the effect look a lot cooler. Now, still in the p-emitter, we're gonna come to region and change it from sphere to bitmap. And that's gonna enable this yellow input right here. And keep in mind that the more particles we have, the more time it'll take Fusion to render the video. So that's important to know. So let's connect our acting to our p-emitter, and we have a kind of a silhouette of our acting right here. But to make this look better, what we have to do is come to p-emitter again, and in controls, where it says color, we're gonna change it from use style color to use color from region. And what this does is basically read out the colors of our input and make the particles look like our acting. So now we're gonna add forces to our particles. So first of all, we're gonna click on the p-emitter, hit shift spacebar, and type PDI. That's for p-directional force. Let's add it. And we're gonna change the direction from minus 90 to 45. Let's throw the render into the viewer. And as you can see, it gave a direction to the particles, which is 45 degrees. So after that, we're gonna add a p-turbulence. And that's gonna add some random movement to our particles. So we're gonna select p-turbulence, and we're gonna change the x, y, and z strengths. So x we're gonna set to 0.2, y to 0.2, and z to 0.3. And density we're gonna set to 35. So now we're gonna create the masks for our effects. So let's put our acting in the first viewer. Now we're gonna grab a polygon mask, put it right here, and we're gonna make a rough mask that will further ahead cover up our whole acting. So let's make a big round circle right here. Okay, so now with our polygon mask selected, we're gonna hit Command C or Control C on the keyboard, and then hit Command Shift V or Control Shift V. And that will create an instance mask, which is a copy of our main mask that will obey the same command. So now, selecting our instance mask, we're gonna come to border width, right click, and then hit T instance. So now, if we change the border width, it'll only affect the instance mask and not the main mask. So let's throw it into the viewer, let's increase the border width, soften the edge a little bit. Okay, now we're gonna grab a merge node, and we're gonna connect our main mask into this yellow input right here, and our instance mask into the green input right here. Now we're gonna come to the merge and change the operator from over to XOR. Next, we're gonna transform these masks into an image. So we're gonna hit shift spacebar and grab a bitmap. Let's add it. Now we're gonna connect our merge into the bitmap. We're gonna make up some room right here And we're gonna grab a matte control. So we're gonna hit shift spacebar and type in matte. Let's add it as well. Now we're gonna connect this between our acting and our PM meter. And we can do that by dragging it on top of this line. Hit shift, and once it gets blue, we can drop it. Now we're gonna connect our bitmap into this gray input right here on the bottom right, the garbage mat. And yeah, this arrow changed places. It's normal, don't worry. Now we're gonna select our mat control, come to garbage mat, and check invert. Now we can see our effects taking shape. Okay, so now we're gonna animate our masks. So let's throw our acting the first viewer. Let's come to, let's say, frame 50. Click on our main mask here and set a keyframe on center. Now we're gonna move it outside of the frame. We're gonna come 2 seconds ahead and cover the whole acting, like this. Now, to wrap up, we're gonna connect everything into our media out. Let's throw it to the second viewer. Now we're gonna make up some room and connect our plate after our pre-render, like this. Then we're gonna make a copy of our acting and its mask and paste it right here. We're gonna also merge it to the node tree. Now, we gotta make sure that our plate is at this yellow input and that our merge 3 is in the green input, meaning the foreground. And the final touch. But before that, make sure to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any more videos that I post here every week. We're gonna grab this main mask right here, copy it, and paste it right here on top of our merge 3. Let's connect it. Then check solid and invert again. And now let's see how it looks. And if you want to learn another editing trick inside DaVinci Resolve, make sure to check out this video showing on your screen right now, and I'll see you there.